What would you say if I told you I had a method to meal plan for your family in less than 30 seconds? And what would you say if I also told you that once you've made that meal plan, I have a different system to help you grocery shop in between 10 and 15 minutes? I know you're probably thinking this is absolutely crazy, there's no way, but that would be amazing. And trust me, I would have said the same thing, but you guys, I have found a system that is literally changing the way we meal plan and grocery shop for our family of three. Let's go ahead and get right into it. Hey friends, if you're new here, my name is Karina. Today I'm sharing with you guys our brand new meal planning and grocery shopping system that is literally saving me so much time, so much energy, and so much stress. I am a wife and I'm a full-time working mom, and honestly, I'm the one who does the meal planning and grocery shopping. So this is a system that is really saving me a ton of time, a ton of energy, and just like brain power that can be contributed somewhere else that is more beneficial in our family than just planning meals. Now, I don't know if you love to meal plan, maybe that's your thing, that's like your absolute jam, and if so, great for you. I know this process will still work for you. But if you are like me, that like you meal plan out of necessity and because you want to save money and you want to feed your family, but you don't love sitting down and like planning out your meals, this system is going to benefit you in so many ways. I'm gonna go ahead and get right into it, but first I wanna say, if you're new here, don't forget to subscribe, and if you are enjoying the video so far, be sure to give me a thumbs up to let me know that you like this video and that you want to see more processes that will help make your life easier, no matter what your stature in life is. If you're a mom, if you're a wife, if you work, if you stay at home, whatever your condition is in life, give me a thumbs up to let me know if you'd like to see some processes to make life easier. Okay, enough chatting, let's get into the meal planning system. All right, friends, so before we get started, I wanna say that you can implement this system just using a notepad and a piece of paper. I happen to really like planners and organizing my thoughts and my life on paper in a planner. So that's what I'm using. This is a happy planner, but you do not have to do that. You can just use a notebook or a piece of paper or whatever is more convenient for you. So I'm just gonna go ahead and go over to my meal plan section here. And this is where the money is. This is like the magic sauce right here. So within this home planner from Me and My Big Ideas, they have these weekly menu plans. And it also has a grocery list here on the side. So what I did is I made a master list. And then what I did is for each day, I picked out a different theme that we are going to stick to in our family. So Monday, we have Wild Card Monday. Tuesday is Mexican or Taco Tuesday. Wednesday is going to be Italian or American. Thursday is leftovers. Friday is pizza or takeout. Saturday is typically our date night. I also added Saturday to be something new, like a new recipe, because for me, Saturdays give me more time to cook than the weekdays do, or an easy staple. So if we're either going on a date, if I'm being super lazy and just wanna throw something in really quick, or if I'm feeling super adventurous and want to try a new recipe, I can do that. And then Sunday, because we have a busy day on Sunday with church and family events, I did a crock pot or sheet pan meal for Sundays. And then here on the side, I just have a grocery list of staple items that we keep in our house. This is not everything. I need to kind of go through and finish it, but it's a pretty like generic, easy list. So these are things that I want to make sure we have on hand when I go to the grocery store. I found that with Walmart pickup, I often just focus on the actual meals that I'm planning to cook, and I sometimes forget staples. So this is really beneficial to help me remember to pick these things up because they go into recipes and we use them all the time. So I just have milk, almond milk, eggs, butter, sugar, fruit, and veggies. Okay, so now this is really where the money or the time saving happens, is on the next sheet here. Okay guys, so then on the back of this page are snack and quick bites, recipe/meal prep. I actually use this section for breakfast ideas, and then I cut it in half. So half is for breakfast, half is for lunch. And up here, I just have the snacks that we like to eat. It's just like kind of generic things, snack plate, yogurt, snack cakes, rice cakes and nut butters, cookies, crackers and cheese, trail mix, protein bars, fruit and nut butter, veggies and dip, hard boiled eggs, things like that. Just simple practical things to get me started with our meal plan and just remember to grab a couple snack options for the week. And then moving into breakfast ideas, this is super helpful. We don't usually eat breakfast as a family except for on the weekend. So I like to have things that are easy for my husband to either make or grab, and same for myself. So I just have our favorite list ideas here for breakfast items. So waffles, peanut butter, and bacon, and like bananas to go on top of the waffles, pancakes with sausage and eggs, French toast and sausage, egg McMuffins and fruit, cereal, protein shakes. And then this I love also because for lunch ideas, I often get kind of stuck with figuring out what to prep for the week for lunches. So I just wrote out a bunch of ideas and I'll grab one each week, and that's what I prep for our lunches. So meatballs, zucchini noodles or zoodles, and pasta sauce, tri-tip veggies and rice, chicken, sweet potatoes and veggies, taco bowls or taco salads. Protein snack plates, so that's like hard-boiled eggs, meats and cheeses, fruit, trail mix, stuff like that. And then tortellini pesto with chicken and veggies. So all of these things are pretty interchangeable. Like the tri-tip could be any protein, you can choose any veggie, you can do rice, you can do cauliflower rice, you can do potatoes, you can do whatever you want. But these are just great ideas to get me started and to give me a really simple plan for what it is that I want to make. And then if I'm inspired by something on this list and want to do something a little different, then I will do so. But this helps to just get me started and get me on the right direction with the meal plan. And then this is really where the money is, I honestly feel like. So what I did was with this master, I then went through and I picked out five different meal plans for the week. And I just went off of meals that we already know and like, and I labeled each meal plan. So this is meal plan number one. Monday would be salmon with lemon butter, cauliflower mash, and veggies. And then Tuesday we have tacos and Spanish rice. Wednesday, meatballs, pasta, veggies, and garlic bread. Thursday would be leftovers. Friday would be pizza or takeout. Saturday would be date night or a new recipe. Sunday would be crock pot, and I have salsa chicken bowls or tacos. And then the great thing about this is once I have all of these meals listed out here, I write the grocery list. And honest to goodness, you guys, this is saving me so much time and energy, honestly, in the middle of the week. It is so great. So I just go ahead and list out each ingredient that I need for the meals. And I actually went like meal by meal and went through, okay, salmon, I would, need lemons if we don't have any. I would need cauliflower mash and then a veggie. And I just pick a veggie. And I wrote it here, and broccoli, and that could be changed out. I could also change out the cauliflower mash for rice if I wanted to. So, and I just went meal by meal and did the same thing for each one. And then I also added a couple of things, like here I have backup meal. So something easy that I can just throw in, just an extra meal on to have on hand. I also did a frozen pizza here for like the Saturday night in case we're having a super lazy night, or if we just want pizza on Friday, like this meal plan says. So then I went literally and made four more of those. So week number two, burgers and fries, chicken enchiladas, rice and beans, shrimp Alfredo and broccoli, leftovers, pizza and takeout, date night or nuggets and fries or a new recipe. Sunday, pot roast with potatoes, carrots, and bulila, which is bread. And then again, all of the ingredients are listed right here to make those recipes. And then same thing with number three. I'm not going to read it to you guys, but you get the idea. Week number four, same thing. And week number five. And with each week, I try to do something a little bit different, which is why I really like Wildcard Monday. That can be a day that I am feeling like cooking a little bit longer or more intensive than the other nights. That can be something that we already have on hand that I want to just get eaten up. That can be something that we haven't tried before, but it doesn't have a specific category that we're kind of like, not pigeonholed into, but that we're really working off of. It's just kind of whatever we're feeling like. So if we see something like on Pinterest that looks amazing, I can add it as our wild card meal in place of like shrimp, veggie, and rice. So that is literally what I've done. And then when I'm making my grocery list, obviously I have all of the things here for each recipe, but then I also refer back to my staples list, which is right here. I go through and ask myself, okay, do I have enough eggs for this week? Do I have enough butter? What kind of fruit do we want for our lunch snacks? And then I also pick out a breakfast item, just one that we can eat on the weekends or, like kind of a morning that we have a little bit more time. I pick one lunch and I pick a couple of snacks. And literally that is it. And that is all it takes for me to meal plan for a week for our family. Okay, so now that you've seen this system, I want to share with you a few benefits to it that we have found in our own family. And honestly, it's only good to have a system if it is benefiting you. So a few ways that it has benefited our family and that I think are major wins for this system. Number one is that anyone can choose a meal plan. If you have bigger kids, or even toddlers, I guess would work too, you can let your family decide what the meal plan is. I often say to my husband, okay, which meal plan would you like to do this week? He will either just throw out a number or he'll actually look them over and decide from there. But it makes it so easy and it's super fun to incorporate the whole family. The other thing that's so great about it is that it's super versatile. You can change up the meals within this structure. You can have just loosely based plans. If you do like those theme nights, you can move meals around as your schedule needs. If you have different things that come up during the week, you can move a meal around because you already have the ingredients, you know what the plan is. And what I like to do with my plan is I incorporate some meals that require more time cooking and meals that are super like hands-off cooking, like chicken nuggets and french fries versus like chicken enchiladas. So I try to incorporate different things because I know our week can change in a moment's notice sometimes, but also they change week to week. So some nights you will have two meetings or you'll have different events to go to, but some weeks you won't have anything and you have all the free time to cook. So you can really be versatile and adjust things as you need for your family. The other thing is that it saves literally so much time. Not only do you have the meal plan already planned out, you just have to transfer it onto like a whiteboard if you have that in your kitchen to share it with everyone what the meals are for the week, but you also know already what you need to get at the grocery store. So I use Walmart grocery pickup and I will literally just take the grocery list that's on this meal plan sheet already and I'll go over to my Walmart grocery app and buy my groceries, or you know, put them in the cart. And then my husband can pick up the groceries, I can pick up the groceries, I can even, you know, have a friend or a neighbor pick up the groceries. It doesn't really matter. You can really save so much time with that. It honestly used to take me like an hour to pick out just groceries, let alone just picking out the meals. So this system takes me probably 15, maybe 20 minutes at the most, if I'm being like super particular or if I want, you know, to add different new meals in or something like that. But honestly, it saves so much time. Oh wait. Another benefit to this system is that it makes it so easy to be consistent. And whatever we can do that is consistent is what we will do continually. So that's where where you see the benefits of a system like this. You can't just do it once and call it good. Like, you have to do it. This system makes it so easy to be consistent with your meal plans, which makes it really easy to be consistent with eating at home and saving money. And you can just kind of see like the ripple effects start to happen, right? You get to create these habits that benefit your family in way more ways than just saving you, the grocery picker, money picking out groceries. So friends, I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you are new to my channel, be sure to subscribe so you don't miss a single video that I do share. And if you've enjoyed this, if you find this helpful and you're going to implement it in your own life, be sure to give me a thumbs up and let me know you enjoyed it. Comment below what is one thing you're taking away to make your meal planning easier. I'll talk to you soon, friends. Have a great day.